for West Cumbria. Police in South Cumbria are appealing for witnesses to a fatal road accident just after midnight last night. 20-year-old John Douglas Hall from Barrow died after his car left the road and hit a wall at Goads Barrow near Alverston. An inquest opens later today into the death of a Merseyside man whose body was found in a car near Keswick. His name won't be released till relatives have been informed. Police say the death isn't suspicious. An inquest will open this morning on a henching a man who died while baling hay yesterday. 28-year-old Alan Mason was found with serious injuries in a field near Seascale. Emergency services rushed to the field, but Mr. Mason was pronounced dead by a local doctor. Police say there are no suspicious circumstances. Home Secretary Douglas Hurd dealt a blow to hopes of recruiting more police officers to help fight rising crime in Northumbria. His department has written to the Area Police Authority saying no more money is available this year. Authority members are now planning to send a deputation to London in a bid to get the minister to change his mind. Police in the Isle of Man are looking for a woman missing from home since last Friday morning. They say they're concerned for the safety of Mrs. Ross Woodhead, aged about 47, of Church Road, Port Erin. She disappeared in her white Renault car, B29 Man, and owners of garages and barns are being asked to check inside them in case the car is there. The Isle of Man, which lost its last two cinemas in April, is to get a new one, costing more than £500,000. The Palace Group, which sold the Strand Cinema and the Picture House in Douglas for property development, is to build the new one in the Palace Lido complex on Douglas Seafront. A new centre is to be used in time of local or national emergencies to be provided in Berwick. The Borough Council is to spend £155,000 adapting property near the town centre. The Home Office is to make a grant of 75% towards the centre. Work is expected to start later this year. Police are investigating a fire which damaged part of a £5 million housing scheme in Dumfries. The blaze damaged floorboards and windows in a flat in Dalswinton Avenue in Dumfries. No one was hurt. That's news this morning. Very good morning to you.